my head.
Hi, I'm Maya Grobel, and welcome to How Hollywood Works. You may have seen today's guest in his tuxedo on March the 23rd at the Academy Awards, where his film Waco, The Rules of Engagement, about the 1993 incident in Waco, Texas, was nominated for Best Feature-Length Documentary. My guest, William Gazecki, wrote, directed, and produced it. The film has already won several awards, including the International Documentary Association's Distinguished Documentary Achievement Award, and the Charleston International Film Festival Gold Medal, among them. Prior to his documentary work, William Gazecki was involved in music production, specializing in sound mixing for film and television, receiving 4 Emmy nominations for his work in dramatic television series, including Hill Street Blues, Moonlighting 30-something, and he won an Emmy for Saint Elsewhere. He now has his own company, Ultravision, and I'm very pleased to have him on the show. Welcome, William.
Thank you.
Documentarians often go unnoticed by the general public. Did the Academy Award help to bring your documentary into the limelight?
Well, certainly. You know, documentaries in general are a specialized field with an audience that generally seeks them out because they don't get a lot of television exposure in the general television marketplace, which is where a lot of films really get their greatest audiences by the time they're shown on television. Although, because this was about such a controversial subject, and because we premiered at the Sundance Film Festival last January, there was quite a bit of visibility, and it was reviewed in a number of papers. I think it's screened in 40 cities around the country.
Wow. Now. What did that nomination mean to you personally and professionally?
Well, personally, it was a tremendous, the feeling was something I did not expect at all. I got the phone call about 6 o'clock in the morning. You're nominated, you're in.
Wow.
And it's a high, actually. It's really a sense of, and I've sort of looked at it and looked about how I felt about it, and it's a feeling of validation in a way that was different than, say, my Emmy nomination or an Emmy win. Perhaps it's a different point in my life, or the way in which I was involved with the film was much more extensive and a much greater effort on my part than some of the other awards and situations I've been involved with in the past.
Mm-hmm.
So it was quite, on a personal level, it was very important. It was very important. It's continued to be, give me a sense of comfort or sort of a relaxed sort of, you know, feeling about my future or what I'm doing in my life.
Definitely.
It really is a very special thing.
How competitive was the documentary category this year? You were up against Spike Lee's film Four Little Girls.
Yes, Spike.
There's a lot of them that were.
The 5 nominees are Four Little Girls by Spike Lee.
Yeah.
A film on Ayn Rand. One called The Long Way Home, which is a Holocaust film.
Yeah.
And one called Color Straight Up, which is a teen. Sort of fame and meets the gangs kind of together.
Mm-hmm.
And shot here in LA, produced here in Los Angeles. And the competition in general, I think, was quite great. I think there were 200 submissions, if I'm not mistaken, to the documentary category.
So it was very competitive.
Oh, very much so.
And was Spike Lee the favorite, just because he never had any of his films win?
Well,
anything?
You know, these Academy Award situations are extensive in their the way in which they're applied within each person's career, how they're strategized and how they're publicized. And Spike Lee has a lot of interest in the political nature of his work. And he's also spent a lot of effort in trying to promote what his film is about and what a statement it is politically. And I think it's different with every film. I think they're all made with different kinds of motivation and different kinds of expectations.
Mm-hmm. What do you think judges are looking for? Not only for the Academy Awards, but you've won the World Fest Houston Special Jury Award for your Waco piece and the Atlanta Film Festival Audience Award as well. What do judges look for when they're judging a documentary?
Well, I don't know a lot of judges myself, but I'll know what I look for, and I know what I look for when I made it, and it is an impact of sorts. It is to be educated and also to be affected by what I'm looking at. And I would think that that's what judges would want to look for primarily. I think there's also, technical considerations. Is it well made? Is it well crafted? Is it nicely timed and visually engaging and things like that? But I think the bottom line is, does it grab one? Does it grab you? Does it really affect you? Does it involve your sense of your? Does it involve your mind or your emotions? Mm-hmm. Does it evoke a certain kind of response?
Yeah.
And that was what was the most primary interest to me.
Mm-hmm. Well, we have a clip from Waco and from Waco, the Rules of Engagement from the documentary. So why don't we go ahead and take a look at that?
We never went in. We did not introduce fire into this compound. It was not our intention that this compound be burned down. I can't tell you the shock and the horror that all of us felt when we saw those flames coming out there. It was, oh my God, they're killing themselves.
I just hope everyone doesn't jump to making decisions before they've heard our side. Right now, all you're hearing is the press. You're hearing a very perverted press. Trust God, read your Bible, know what you're talking about. What are you doing with your life? What do you do every day with your life? Is it something God approves of? I mean, before you judge us, make sure your own life is clean. We're being stripped naked.
We believe that this thing had to be brought to a logical conclusion at some point. We never fired one single round of ammunition.
Were there rules of engagement by the FBI? What were they?
Yes, they were, that they would not shoot unless someone's life was in danger.